This is Andrew from Email Marketing and NYC. In today's video, I'll show you how to design emails right there in Klaviyo. I record this video because I work with many companies where they have in-house designer. And since our agency, we do not provide design, but I know and I do respect like great appealing emails that graphic designer designs, but my job is for customer to make sure the emails gets to inbox so it has better deliverability and it looks good as on like desktop as well as on mobile. That's why when I start working with companies, I have deep conversation with a designer and explain them how they can achieve the same thing what they do in Photoshop or Illustrator, same thing in Klaviyo. So basically they will do the same job, but approach is a little bit different, and I explain you why in this video. So if you're a designer or you have a designer, I highly recommend to let them watch this video. And if I'm too slow for you, you can hold on. Right there below, click on the gears sign and put 1.5 speed or 2x speed, and it will speed up the process and smooth out all my mistakes. Okay, so let's go to your Klaviyo account and let's use email templates. Since for designers, I highly recommend to use templates. Because you can create all templates here, and then somebody like me or somebody on your team can build, use those templates to build flows and build campaigns. And by the way, if you're owner and watching this information, you can have custom access for your designer so they don't see numbers, how much you make, if you want to hide that information. And on YouTube, I created a video how to add users to Klaviyo account and what permission levels. So, okay, so let's do this example. So this is the thing that I use for the different company. Actually, let's start from scratch. It will be much easier. Create template. Let's do basic one. Let's do column number one. First, majority of designers are familiar with MailChimp design, and if you're not, it's fine. But Klaviyo is very simple, similar to MailChimp in terms of drag and drop, but it's more robust. So basically, like everything that you see here on the left, it's drag and drop, and you add your text here. It's very easy to add. This is the fonts you have. This is sizes. So it's like Word document or something, you can add it. So it's not very hard to do that. Also, there's two options. You have a block where you add that block specifically, or you also there's block styles. Let's say if you want to have like font different color, you can change font right here. But you can do as well here. One supersedes another. Also, like let's say image split. Like if you want to have a split, two columns, three columns, more columns, then you can have a button. Then you can have a header. Let's say if you want to use some kind of like header, then you have to play a lot with this because it would be hard for me to show like all possibilities. But honestly, since you're a designer, it would, if you play for probably 30 minutes, 1 hour, you'll figure out how to use it. You can use drop shadow if you want that. And here you can use columns, like if you want to split the email. But for graphic designers, since you used to use, you use everything in like Photoshop or Illustrator, I'll show you how to combine those features and how to break down your emails. So Let's go to this really good emails. But by the way, this is a great source for inspiration. I highly recommend to check to see what other companies do. And let's use this email. So the common mistake I see, people use one image. I already saved it. So this is how they create email. So they use this email, upload, browse, and let's do this and upload. And they do right here, you can fit image to area, and it looks amazing email. It's like, honestly, it's hard to desire something better. It looks everything amazing. However, this is the, Okay, let's delete this. And let's delete that. Okay, so I mean, everything looks good. However, just imagine person receiving this email and they have images turned off on Gmail or Outlook. I mean, they receive just empty email. So this is a big problem for deliverability, because they will either click spam or click unsubscribe, because you're sending them empty emails with nothing in them, and you're wasting their time. Another problem with this kind of email where you have only one image, mobile. This, like, as you can see, Star Wars looks good. Me, Yudis, I don't know how to read it. It looks good. This looks fine. But look at this. And this is like common problem. It's so small, I cannot read it. I mean, I hardly can read it. Maybe you say, like, you don't need to be read because there is unsubscribe. Yeah, correct, but something, and this might be too small. So you want to create emails which adjustable to mobile or desktop or tablet. And how to do it? So for example, how would I recommend to edit this template? First, I would recommend to split in terms of split images. So first, I would recommend to designer is to split this part, like this one, or maybe even right here. It will be block number one. Then since this custom email, the custom font, I will split this block as well. Then I will insert image. Then I will remove this or move it down, or like I remove all that. And I'll tell them to use this as a text block, font block, and this as a font block, and on black background with white font. Then I will tell them to use this as a button, custom button, like this button, which one right here. Yeah. So at which block style, and let's say it's square, so you don't need radius. Then you need something bigger. So you do like 30, maybe something bigger. You need like 60 or 90. I mean, you have to play with that, and you want text. And you want background is blue, but block background, you want black. Yeah, so this is how you mimic this button, and then you create another one, and now you have two. But this way, when you do, you can see, I mean, you have to play with that, but this adjusts to mobile device. It makes text bigger and readable to on mobile devices. Okay, so what's next? So then all this, it's text block, social media block, text block. It doesn't have to be image. In general, as I said, many clients, they design one email in Photoshop or Illustrator, export as one image. In the best case, they slice it as a different images. So like as this email, but different images, like instead of this one as one image, they have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 like blocks, and they insert as separate images, which a little bit better. But again, if the image option turned off on Gmail Outlook, they will, the customer will not see the email. But let's say you send it and the image is not enabled, so they do not see your logo, they do not see this picture, or but they see this right here, and right. And I just went to Digital Marketer because it's probably the first article I read years ago about email marketing for e-commerce. So this is a great example from Tony Robbins. And as you can see, the same email with no images and with images. So as you can see, when you receive this kind of email, if there is no images, you're not missing anything, because all information is right here. I mean, if it's with images, it'll look much better. But without images, you're receiving information. Maybe you do not receive pretty pictures, but you're receiving the same information. So this is what I'm trying to convey to you, that either you send email with images or without images, person should receive the same kind of information. I showed you how to use designer, like email Klaviyo, email designer, Klaviyo email designer, drag and drop, how to do that. Feel free to ask me any kind of questions below, because for me to use this designer is like second nature. For you, it might be new. So please, please, please let me know if you have any additional questions. I will be more than glad to help you out. And also subscribe to this YouTube channel, because we're releasing daily video for the next year, how to better use Klaviyo. Thank you.